It has been a long time, but welcome back to Cooking It Old School. This is a really cool recipe because it is very, very simple, even easier than the inside-out grilled cheese we made last time, which is really cool. But it's simple, and if you guys like ramen, I know a lot of college students live off that stuff. You could easily make this for very cheap, and it doesn't take long at all. So let's get into it. So you're gonna need a pot to cook the noodles in, obviously. You're gonna need the instant noodles. Any kind of instant noodles works. I mean, I like Mr. Noodle, but it really doesn't matter. You're gonna need 2 tablespoons of butter. You know, obviously this isn't, you know, the exact measurement, but it doesn't really matter about the exact measurements. A 1/4 cup of milk. I mean, I don't have a 1/4 cup, so I just kind of filled 1/3 cup. And a colander. Colander, fancy word for big bowl with lots of holes in it. Used for draining stuff, obviously. So first you're gonna wanna fill your bowl with, I don't know, about 2 cups of water, it really doesn't matter. And then you're gonna put it on high heat and let the water boil. Obviously this is the first step if you're gonna wanna make regular ramen, so yeah. Once the water's boiled, you can just put the brick of ramen in and continue as normal. I mean, this stuff right now is pretty much basic if you make ramen. You're gonna wanna put the brick in and stir, you know, separate the noodles for about 2 to 3 minutes. You know, once you're done, you should have all the noodles separated, all the noodles cooked, and you know, that's pretty much it. Now we're gonna go on to the next step, which is a bit unique. So next, you're gonna wanna drain the noodles in the colander, or the big bowl with all the holes, you know. This is something you don't really do with the regular ramen, but this is where it starts to get interesting. So yeah, just drain the noodles, and then we'll go on to the next step. Now you're going to want to turn the ring off and put the noodles back in the pan. So now with your drained noodles, you're going to want to add the milk, and you're going to want to add the 2 tablespoons of butter. And here's a trick. If you can never get the spoon, if you have to wrestle the butter off of the spoon, hold the spoon against the hot noodles. It'll melt the butter a little bit, and you can easily get the butter off the spoon and into the noodles. This is a little trick of mine. Now this next part's really easy. You just gotta mix it all together. You know, you gotta melt the butter. It's gonna be really easy with the milk to get it all mixed together. But you're gonna mix it all together until you get a nice creamy ramen. It's just delicious. And after that, you're just gonna wanna add in the soup powder to give it that flavor and mix that in, and you're done. Now what you have is this amazing, filling, hearty, creamy ramen that is just absolutely delicious. And if a noodle falls out of the pan onto the stove, make sure to report that to your local police station. They'll take care of it. It's really just an out. You guys should make this for yourselves and let me know how it went. Let me know if you want to add your own touches. You know, I've added cheese to it before. That's really good. You know, just add your touches to it. It's gonna be really good. It's a delicious meal. It's very cheap. It's easy to make. So college students, stop eating that like noodles and soup, gross stuff. Enjoy!